Are you big? Are you small? Do you listen when the wild winds call? Are you wise but learning still? Well, come on in if you will. Welcome to my Storytime Place. I'm glad you're here. My name is Rachel. We're going to have a lot of fun on my Storytime Place. We're going to have stories, songs, and puppets. Speaking of puppets, this is my friend Cow. Everybody say, hi, Cow.
Hi, Cow.
Do you know what time it is now, Cow?
It's time to move.
What time is it now? It's puppet time.
Three little birdies sitting in their nest when their mama said, "Go to sleep, my babies. You need to get your rest." But the baby said,
"Don't go, mama. We're begging you to stay. Read us a story before you fly away. Read us a story before you fly away."
The mama said, "Oh, my little babies, I have so much to do. I'll never get my work done if I read a book to you." But those babies said,
"Don't go, mama, we're begging you to stay. Read us a story before you fly away. Read us a story before you fly away."
"Oh, I have to get my groceries, some berries and a bug. Now hush-a-bye, sweet lullaby, with kisses and a hug." But those babies said,
"Don't go, mama, we're begging you to stay. Read us a story before you fly away. Read us a story before you fly away."
I'll read you a story, 'cause I love you so, and I'll find the time to read to you before I have to go. Yes, I'll find the time to read to you before I have to go.
It's me, Coconut, your favorite monkey puppet. And I'm going to tell you one of my favorite knock-knock jokes. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Okay, here we go. Knock-knock.
Who's there?
Harry!
Harry who?
Harry up and close the door! It's cold in here!
Wiggle your fingers and your hands this way. Here's Miss Ginger with a finger play.
Here are Grandma's glasses. Here is Grandma's hat. This is the way she folds her hands, just like that. Here are Grandpa's glasses. Here is Grandpa's hat. This is the way he folds his arms, just like that. This is a finger play called Grandma's Glasses. I'll teach it to you now, and then we can try it together. First, you take your finger and your thumb, and you make little circles like this. Can you try that? Those are Grandma's glasses. And then she has a small little hat, so you just make a small little hat on your head like that with your hands. And then she folds her hands in her lap, one on top of the other, just like that. Now, Grandpa has great big glasses, so we make kind of a C shape with our hands like this, make some great big glasses. And Grandpa has a great big hat, so we hold our hands far apart, like that, to make the great big hat. And then he folds his arms, just like that. Let's try it together. You ready? Here are Grandma's glasses. Here is Grandma's hat. This is the way she folds her hands, just like that. Here are Grandpa's glasses. Here is Grandpa's hat. This is the way he folds his arms, just like that.
Here's Miss Emily with a storybook. Put on your listening ears, your looking eyes, and your very quiet mouth.
Hello. We're going to read a story today that comes from the Choctaw Nation. It's called When Turtle Grew Feathers by Tim Tingle, illustrated by Stacy Schuett. Now, most everybody knows about the race between turtle and rabbit, but the Choctaw people tell it differently. They say the reason Rabbit couldn't outrun Turtle was that he wasn't even racing a turtle at all. He only thought he was. That all took place on the day when Turtle grew feathers. Now, Turkey was walking in the grass by the lake, and he was stretching his long, skinny neck, not watching where his feet fell. Turkey didn't see Turtle napping in the grass. Crack! Crack! You stepped on my back, said Turtle. My shell is shattered like glass.
Well, I'm not to blame, said Turkey. You sleep too low in the grass.
But my shell is my home, said Turtle. You broke my beautiful shell.
Well, that's your fault, said Turkey, not mine. I'm tired of hearing you yell.
So Turkey lifted his wings to fly away.
Wait, said Turtle. Let's call a truce and not fight.
Turkey smiled and nodded. Let's do what we know to be right. And just then an army of ants paraded by.
Friends, said Turkey, help us mend this shell, and then I'll help you gather your dinner until your little bellies swell.
So the ants went to work, and with threads of silk from the cornfield, they sewed Turtle's shell together.
Turtle climbed into his shell. It felt as good as new.
Well,
I'm sorry for your trouble, said Turkey, but I like your shiny shell.
Do you want to try it on? Said Turtle. I think you would look just swell.
Well, I believe I would, said Turkey.
And Turtle shimmied out of his shell, and Turkey climbed right in. He stuck his long neck out the front, and he pushed his wings through the side, and he poked his skinny long legs out the back of the turtle shell. Now, about that time, five little bitty turtles came huffing and puffing and running down the path.
Everybody hide, said the little bitty turtles cried.
What is it? Asked Turtle, his eyes open wide.
Oh, here comes Rabbit, said the little bitty five. Rabbit wants to race and he won't be denied.
Turkey pulled in his wings and his legs into Turtle's shell. He drew his head inside and he peeked out the front.
In the flick of an eye, Rabbit burst into the clearing.
Hoo! I feel fast, he said. I'm ready to race. Who wants a little mud in the face?
He spotted Turtle's shell lying on the ground.
How about you, Turtle? How about a little race?
Turkey lay in Turtle's shell and he didn't say a word. Rabbit moved closer.
Hey, I said, how about you, Turtle? How about a little race?
And finally, from where he hid in the grass, Turtle yelled,
get it on!
Rabbit jumped back. Why, he'd never been talked to like that before. He scratched a line in the dirt, he puffed his chest out, and he said, you made me mad, my slowpoke friend. Your racing days are about to end. Turkey waddled to the starting line. Seemed to take forever. Finally, Rabbit said, once around the lake when I say go, and you be careful not to run too slow. Well, Turkey poked his head out and looked around. Rabbit had never seen a turtle like that before. And while he watched, the neck kept growing and growing and growing. Rabbit was beginning to get a little worried. On your mark, said Rabbit. Well, long, skinny legs grew out of the turtle shell. Rabbit couldn't believe what he was seeing. Get set, he said. But the strangest thing was yet to come. All of a sudden, wings popped out of the turtle shell. Long, slow, flapping wings. Rabbit was downright scared by now. He stuttered, he stammered. He finally shouted, go! And Turkey took off in an explosion of dust. His legs were churning and his wings were flapping. Rabbit stayed behind, choking in the dust. And just as he was about to take off, he heard a sound behind him. Screech! Turkey was coming in for a landing. He had already circled the lake. Turkey glanced over at Rabbit. He adjusted his shell till it fit properly. He dusted off his feathers, and then he strutted across the finish line. Rabbit looked on. He was barely able to speak. His eyes were as big as itty-bitty turtle shells. For the first time ever, Rabbit couldn't think of a single thing to say. He hung his ears and went, hip-hoppity. Hip-hoppity, hip-hoppity, off to where rabbits hide. Now, Rabbit never challenged Turtle again, and that's why you will never see them racing today. Now, that's the way the Choctaw tell the story. It all took place, they say, on the day when Turtle grew feathers. It was a day of great learning as well. Turtle learned you don't have to be the biggest, or the fastest, or the best. But it sure is nice to be friends with those that are. Now, this story is your story.
Why, hello. My name is Miss Mayberry. I am a librarian. Well, you know, as a librarian, I love books. I love to read. I love to use my brain and think. I was wondering, what did you learn from that story? And while you're thinking about that, here is Mr. Andrew with a craft.
Hey there, time for a craft with Mr. Andrew. So today we learned about the turtle that grew feathers. And so we're gonna make something that's gonna look pretty crazy at the end, but it's gonna be pretty fun. And so here's all you need. First of all, we need our green piece of paper for our turtle shell. And then we've got a piece for our head. And we've got some shapes for our feathers. And gotta have a beak. And then this is his wattle. That's the thing that goes right here. Gobble, gobble. And some feet and some googly eyes. And then of course all you need over here is you need your scissors to cut out your shapes. I use the big scissors, but you be sure and use your safety scissors. And then we've got our glue stick and a marker. And so now I've already used my scissors. So before we start gluing anything, we're gonna draw on the outside of our shell so it looks a little bit more like a shell, because we've got the green piece right like that, and we're gonna make a circle here, just kind of follow the edge all around there, and it can be a little wavy and wiggly. And then we're going to do a line down like this, and we're going to line down like that, and we're going to do a line across like this, and another one there, and another one there. See, now it looks more like a tortoise shell. Good stuff. Okay, so now that we've done that, we're gonna turn it over, and we're gonna start gluing. So let's see, let's get our glue stick. First, we're gonna put on our head. So squib, squib, squib. We'll put that there. And then we're gonna do our feathers. And what I'm gonna do, we're gonna glue them down here together first. So we'll do squib, like that, and put the other one on. And squib, right there. And then put the third one on. So it'll look just like that. And then we'll put a squib right here, squib. And put it right over like that. Okay, and then we're gonna do another one of those on the other side. And then we're gonna take our feet and do a squib right there. Put it right there. And a squib right here. And put it right there. Okay, so now we're ready to turn it over. Turn it back over. And now all we need to do is the face. And so let's put the beak first. So we're gonna do squib, squib, squib. Put the beak right there. And then we gotta do his wattle. That's the thing that goes right here. So his wattle, whoops. Squib, squib. And we'll do that like that. And then, of course, the googly eyes. So let's just squib right there. And the other one, squib right there. There we go. Okay, and so when we're done, you're gonna have this kooky character that is the turtle that grew feathers. Gobble, 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 gobble.
Here's a special song just for you.
There was a great big moose.
There was a great big moose.
He liked to drink a lot of juice.
He liked to drink a lot of juice.
There was a great big moose.
There was a great big moose.
He liked to drink a lot of juice.
He liked to drink a lot of juice.
Singing no way oh.
Singing no way oh.
Well, well, well. Way
oh, way
way oh, way oh, way oh,
way
oh,
way oh, way oh, way oh, way oh, way oh, way oh,
the moose's name was Fred.
The moose's name was
He liked to drink his juice in bed.
He liked to drink his juice in bed.
The moose's name was Fred.
The moose's name was Fred.
He liked to drink his juice in bed.
He liked to drink his juice in bed.
Singing no way ho.
Singing no way ho.
Way ho, way ho, way ho, way ho.
Way ho, way ho, way ho, way ho.
Way ho. Until he got some in his hair.
Until he got some in his hair.
He drank his juice with care.
He drank his juice with care.
Until he got some in his hair.
Until he got some in his hair.
Singing no way ho.
Singing no way ho.
Way ho, way ho, way ho, way ho. Now he's a sticky moose.
Now he's a sticky moose.
All covered in juice.
All covered in juice.
Singing no way ho.
Singing no way ho.
Way ho, way ho, way ho, way ho.
Way ho, way ho, way ho, way ho.
Way ho, way ho.
Way ho, way ho.
Way ho, way ho, way ho, way ho.
Everybody, we're going to do some counting today with Miss Emily.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi.
I brought one of my favorite counting books. Oh. This is The Big Fat Hen by Keith Baker.
It's a beautiful book.
I know. It's so pretty. The hens are beautiful colors. And there's lots of things to count because hens lay...
eggs.
Eggs. We get to count the eggs. And we get to count the chicks that come out of the eggs. And if you want to, you can count the little things that the hen eats.
What are those, worms?
They are. Hens eat worms and bugs.
Ooh.
I know. And here she's eating snails. Lots of good things to count in this book. So if I'm going to do a counting activity afterwards, all I need is an egg carton. Because egg cartons have lots of spaces to put things in to count.
What are those?
They're pom-poms. They look just like chicks, don't they?
Oh, they do.
So I made a counting piece of paper. And it has four squares. You want to count them?
I will. One, two, three, four.
So once I have all my chicks in my egg carton, I can count them on the paper. So here we go. There's one.
I'll do two.
Okay.
One, two.
Very good. I'll do three.
One, two, three. I'll do four. I will. One, two, three, and here's a teeny tiny chick.
Oh, he's so cute.
Four.
So you can count inside the egg carton or on a number sheet, or you can even put your little chicks in an egg if you have any left over from Easter. All right, so, and there's a rhyme that goes with this book. You ready to do the rhyme,
yes,
Rachel?
Yes, I am.
Here we are.
Let's get the shoes.
Let's get everything over the way. So it goes like this.
One, two, buckle my shoe. Three, four, shut the door. Five, six, pick up sticks. Seven, eight, lay them straight. Nine, ten, the big fat hen.
Oh, that's just one way you can practice counting.
With a book, like Big Fat Hen by Keith Baker.
Which side of the chicken has the most feathers?
I don't know. Which side?
The outside. C is the way to begin. H is the second letter in. I am the third. And C is the fourth letter in that word. K, just fill it in. E, get near the end. C-H-I-C-K-E-N. That's the way you spell chicken. Chicken, chicken, bawk, bawk. Chicken, chicken, bawk, bawk. Chicken, bawk, chicken, bawk. Chicken, chicken, bawk, bawk. Bawk, 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 bawk
Wiggle your fingers and your arms this way. Here's Aunt Cindy Rose with a finger play.
Hi. Today's finger play is called Five Little Speckled Frogs. Let me show you. Five little speckled frogs sitting on a speckled log, eating a most delicious fly. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are four little speckled frogs. Glub, glub. Four little speckled frogs sitting on a speckled log, eating a most delicious fly. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are three speckled frogs. Glub, glub. Three little speckled frogs sitting on a speckled log, eating a most delicious fly. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are two speckled frogs. Glub, glub. Two little speckled frogs sitting on a speckled log, eating a most delicious fly. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there is one little speckled frog. One little speckled frog sitting on a speckled log, eating a most delicious fly. Yum, yum. He jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are no little speckled frogs. Glub, glub.
I had fun at my story time place. I hope you had a good time too. See you next time. Bye.
Are you big? Are you small? Do you listen when the wild winds call? Are you wise but learning still? Well, come on in if you will. I am bigger than a fly on the wall. Though the mountains think I'm small, I am wise but learning still. Shall I sing for you? I think I will. I always